just give you a little rundown on building up your infield and maybe fixing some things yourself that you can do on your own. And I'll start out with, like Mr. Leffert said, to start out, he has links on his webpage where you can get all your measurements. In case you don't know them all, this is a high school field, of course. Usually what I do when I first get there to do any kind of work on the infield is I try to shape it out. And what I find locally is nobody really has nice straight grass edges on their field. And I think if you do that, you find out your field would look 100% better if you just have nice straight grass edges. So first way, I don't know if many people just don't know the right way to do it to get the right measurements. So I'll just kind of show you real quick. But there's a the second base stick right there. What you do is you get a string line and you go to the middle of that second base stake and you run it to your first base side and you go on the back of the first base bag. So your first base bag will be in the ground and you run your string line off the back of that to the center of the second base stake. And the grass line is supposed to be 3 feet in front of that string line. You probably won't find any fields around here that are. I know the one here passes, but what I usually do, if I can't get it to that 3 feet in front of that string line, I'll get it the closest I can. And that also helps prevent some of the lips that you have built up on your field. I cut them out at the same time. Now, if it gets too bad where you've got to cut back, you know, 2 or 3 feet, you can always cut it back, level that part out, and bring in new sod and fix it that way if you want to make it to right on 3 feet. You do the same thing on the third base side. And your foul lines, I just stretch my foul line out just like you would if you're lining off the field, and you go 3 feet to the foul edge grass also. And a lot of times that's all different. I take care of Highland Park Stadium in Kokomo, and I've made mine, I think it's 7 foot off of that string line just because of guys running a bag and stuff like that. That helps from keeping worn out areas. On your back arch, what you do is you run a straight line from the apex of home plate straight through second base. So that gives you your center. And bring that up from your pitching mound rubber, the front of it, 18 inches. And you go back to your back arch, which is another 5 foot radius. So from that 18 inch mark in front of your rubber, you stretch your measuring tape off 95 feet. And usually I just put the paint can right on that 95-foot mark, bend over and paint it, and squat down and paint it the right way, and that way you get a nice straight line. And usually I paint all my lanes out first, and then go back and either use a saw cutter, an edger, or however you want to do it. But that's an easy way to kind of do it yourself on shaping your field out. I just threw some drag patterns down here in case you guys aren't familiar with some of them. This will help prevent some of them low spots, especially around your bags and where the short shot on second base plays. It's hard to read here, but I know Bill has these on his website. I'm not sure if Leffert has them on his or not. But the first one here is kind of just a finishing drag pattern, going around backwards first and coming up around the edge of the infield grass and going back and forth that way. And the second one's more like a figure eight pattern, and the most popular probably is there is Bob, and that's just a circle drag pattern, and that's especially helpful when filling in low areas. Usually when I drag the field, I'll take out all the bases first. A lot of guys, I think, little leagues especially, leave their bags in. You'll find out your bag's up here, and then you wonder why you got such a low spot around every bag. It's probably more helpful to break around your base areas with a rake instead of trying to get in there with a drag, because you have a tendency to turn your drag and build up lips that way. I just do a couple pictures of drags here. A lot of people around back and cook them, I drag at the bottom. That helps give you a finishing look.
look so bad.
So the first step is you want to stay at least a foot away from all your grass edges. And that way, when you're going around in circles or whichever pattern you're using, you're not kicking all your stuff into the grass and making loops that way. Like I said, don't ever drag into the grass or cover moving the bases. A lot of times on the edges, I'll just use a, even a leaf rake to kind of just go around all my edges. You never want to rake into your grass edges. You always want to rake along with them. So if your players are doing it, that's a helpful hint on that. Not having loops also is always rake along the grass line. So if I'm, this is the grass line, I'm raking this way with it, not pulling it back into it and pushing away from it toward you. Make a hole out with the two. If you use a tractor, try not to go. You have a tendency to drag really fast. That's why I think a lot of people prefer just to hand drag it, so you're not having a tendency to go real fast and make ridges in your field and holes that way. And if you do have low spots, especially around your bags and stuff, instead of